Hi, I'm Steve Luck, and I run the ERP Bootcamp Workshops along with my colleague, Dr. Emily Kappenman. In this series of virtual ERP Bootcamp videos, we'll be explaining the basics of ERP research. I'd like to begin with a completely crazy, preposterous idea, namely that it's possible to record meaningful brain activity from electrodes placed on the skin, with the skull separating the electrodes from the brain. When Hans Berger first recorded the EEG from the human scalp in the 1920s, most neuroscientists thought he was crazy and was just picking up random junk. After all, how could brain activity, produced by tiny little neurons, be conducted through the cortex, pass through the meninges, and cross the skull to the scalp? And yet it works. You can put electrodes on the skin overlying the skull and pick up meaningful brain activity. And it works in just about anyone, even an old thick-headed guy like me. Now, when you look at the raw EEG, it's a pretty complicated signal. It's basically the sum of everything the brain is doing. It can indicate if someone's awake or asleep, but in its raw form, the EEG can't reveal the specific neural processes that underlie perception, cognition, and emotion. However, if we apply a simple set of signal processing operations to the raw EEG, we can pull out portions of the neural activity that are related to specific sensory, cognitive, affective, and motor processes. To do this, we record the EEG while the research subject performs a task. When a stimulus is presented, a marker called an event code is placed in the EEG data file, indicating what stimulus was presented and when it happened. We also have event codes for behavioral responses. A typical experiment would involve many stimuli and many responses. It's also possible to have event codes for things like eye movements and heartbeats. Any discrete, measurable event can be used. By using these event codes, we can process the EEG and extract the electrical potentials, the voltages, that are related to the events. That's what an event-related potential is. It's a voltage, an electrical potential, that's related to an event like a picture on a computer screen, a spoken word, or a button press. So, what can you do with ERPs? You can use them to study the development of face processing in infants and young children. You can use them to track the allocation of attention in complex scenes. You can predict which patients will wake from a coma. And you can see how anxiety and depression change perception, attention, and decision-making. You can use ERPs to understand the origins of individual differences in working memory capacity. And you can even use ERPs to decode the contents of working memory and link brain activity to computational models. Although we can do a lot with ERPs, you always need to remember that it's something of a miracle that we can record brain activity from electrodes placed on the skin, with big, thick skull bones lying between the brain and the electrodes. There are significant limits on the kinds of information that we can extract from EEG signals, so we need to retain a certain amount of humility when we try to study the brain with ERPs. And there are a lot of complicated technical issues involved in ERP research. You need to know how the electrical potentials are generated in the brain and are conducted to the scalp. You need to know how to measure the signals from the scalp and avoid contamination by artifacts. You need to know about a bunch of signal processing steps like filtering, independent component analysis, and signal averaging. You need to know about a variety of experimental design issues. And you need to know how to perform statistical analyses that are unbiased and lead to replicable findings. So, conducting ERP research requires a lot of knowledge and skills. To be honest, we can't teach you all these things in this brief set of videos. But we can give you enough background so that you can read, understand, and critically evaluate published ERP research. And if you want to run your own ERP studies, these videos will give you a starting point for learning how to record and analyze ERPs. Then you can take advantage of the many resources we've provided for new and intermediate ERP researchers. For example, I wrote this book on ERPs, which provides an overview of everything from designing an experiment to performing statistical analyses once the experiment is complete. And if you'd like to take a deep dive into a specific ERP component, Emily and I put together this edited volume, the Oxford Handbook of ERP Components. Emily and I also lead a 10-day summer workshop, the ERP Bootcamp, which is meant for people who already have at least a year of ERP research experience and want to get to the next level. You can also schedule a mini ERP bootcamp at your site. Emily or I will come out for 2 or 3 days and provide customized training, whether you're just getting started or have considerable experience and want to take your research to the next level. If you'd like to try analyzing some ERP data, my lab produces ERPLab Toolbox, a free open source MATLAB package for ERP processing and analysis. It includes a point-and-click user interface, but it also allows you to write MATLAB scripts to automate the processing or implement your own analysis methods. Emily and I have also created a publicly available resource called ERP Core. It's a set of 6 optimized ERP paradigms, each of which takes about 10 minutes to run. We provide the stimulus presentation script so you can run the paradigms yourself. We also provide data from 40 neurotypical young adults so you can try your hand at data analysis. And we provide the ERPLab data processing pipeline so you can see how all the data analysis steps are implemented. These resources and more can be accessed from our erpinfo.org website. We hope you find all this stuff useful. Emily and I both love the ERP technique. How amazing is it that we can record brain activity from electrodes on the skin? So we've made it our mission to help researchers around the world do the best possible ERP research. If you teach undergrads about ERPs, I'd also like to point you to Pursue, an NSF-funded initiative that seeks to create resources for teaching about ERPs. Whether you just want to give a couple of lectures on ERPs in a broader course, teach a whole semester course on ERPs, or get undergrads involved in ERP research, Pursue has resources to help you. I got my start with ERPs when I was a student at Reed College in a previous century, back when I had a lot more hair. Doing ERP research in college taught me a ton of skills, ranging from experimental design to computer programming and multivariate statistical analysis. I want today's college students to have this same opportunity. I'd like to end this video by acknowledging the support of the National Institutes of Health. They funded the in-person ERP bootcamp for over a decade, and they've also provided the funding for this virtual ERP bootcamp course. NIH funding has also supported a lot of the research I'll be discussing. We couldn't do all of this without their support.